أحسن منك لم تركت عيني، وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء. خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب، كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء. The very famous companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, that companion is known as Hassan, the son of Thabit. Sayyiduna Hassan is bestowed with the laqab of Sha'iru Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was the personal poet of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah wasalam, in defense, support and honor of Sayyidina Hassan, said, O Hassan, Inna Allah yu'ayyiduka bi ruhi al-Qudus. I see that Allah Almighty has helped you and assisted you with Sayyidina Jibreel Amin. That every time you praise me, I see that Allah sends Jibreel to assist you and help you in praising me. Inna Allah yu'ayyiduka bi ruhi al-Qudus, ya Hassan. Hassan, Allah assists and helps you through Ruh al-Qudus. The title of Sayyidina Jibreel, Jibra'il or Jibreel, both are correct. Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, that Allah assists and helps you through him, the archangel, the leader of all angels. It is reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in agreeance with what Sayyidina Hassan would say in the praise of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on one occasion they gifted Sayyidina Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu the blessed cloak as an approval to what he says in praise of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. We gift naqain, money, presents. It is hadiya, a gift. There is jawaz through this, because the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam gifted. Where is our gift to these naqain? Where is money compared to what Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam gave to Sayyidina Hassan? By Allah, there is no single naqain present alive who would rather have acceptance, qabuliyyah, in the court of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ahead of receiving thousands or hundreds of pounds as gift from the public. There is not a single naqain, if you ask him, he would say, I would take qabuliyyah, acceptance in the bargah of Rasulullah over everything. Isn't this what Allah Almighty gave to Sayyidina Hassan? That I began my speech with his words and poetry. Sayyidina Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, وَأَحْسَنَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَكَتُ عَيْنِي. My eyes have never seen anyone more haseen than you, ya Rasulullah. وَأَجْمَلَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ. No woman has given birth to anyone more jameel than you, ya Rasulullah. In the Arabic language, haseen and jameel are synonyms. Synonyms in English, because they are both simply translated as beauty. Husn is beauty and Jamal is beauty. But there is a huge difference when you delve into the language. Husn refers to external beauty. Jamal refers to internal beauty. Hazrat Hassan said, وَأَحْسَنَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَكَتُ عَيْنِي. My eyes have never seen anyone more externally beautiful than you, ya Rasulullah. وَأَجْمَلَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ. No woman has given birth to a child who's more internally beautiful than you, ya Rasulullah. Sayyidina Hassan said, whether it's external beauty, whether it's internal beauty, Nabi alayhi salatu was salam is the most beautiful that has ever been created. Wa ahsana minka lam taraqattu ayni. Ayni is murakkab idafi. Mudaf and mudaf ilay. My eyes have never seen. One sha'ir, he changed it and said, wa ahsana minka lam taraqattu aynun. Aynun is nakira in the Arabic language. And it gives the fa'ida of umum. No eye has ever seen. Never mind Sayyidina Hassan's blessed eyes. There are no eyes that have ever seen anyone more extremely beautiful than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No woman has given birth to a child more internally beautiful than you, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Husn and Jamal. This is what I want to talk about. The Husn and Jamal of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The excellent beauty of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Who is more beautiful than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? There is no one more beautiful than him sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the creation of Allah. You may argue that we have been taught from childhood till now, there is no one more beautiful than Sayyidina Yusuf, the son of Sayyidina Yaqub. There is no doubt. Sayyidina Yusuf is undoubtedly one of the most beautiful creations of Allah. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, when Husn was created, beauty, Allah Almighty divided it into two halves. He gave one half of beauty to the rest of creation. One half of beauty was divided amongst everyone. And half of beauty was given to Sayyidina Yusuf. This is how beautiful Sayyidina Yusuf was. This is why Zalikha, she fell in love with him. She was mesmerized by Sayyidina Yusuf's beauty. And then when she made advancements towards Sayyidina Yusuf, and Allah in reality saved Sayyidina Yusuf, but was falsely imprisoned by Zulaykha and the governor's courtiers, Sayyidina Yusuf was imprisoned falsely. Because Zulaykha fell in love with him. Sayyidina Yusuf was tied, shackled, chained in a prison. Rumors spread in the city, in Egypt, in Cairo, that Zulaykha, the governor's wife, has fallen in love with the governor's slave. When this rumor spread, Zulaykha had to present evidence and proof as to why she did what she did. So she called 40 of the leading women in Egypt to a special invitation in her palace. She prepared a meal, a banquet. For each one, there was a sikkim, a knife, and a fruit. And they all sat down and they began to eat. They picked up the apple or the fruit and they began to cut through it. As they were cutting through this apple, Zulaykha ordered her slaves that go and bring Yusuf now. As soon as Sayyidina Yusuf came, tied shackled, head lowered, and behold, before the eyes of these women stood Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. They, upon looking at Sayyidina Yusuf, became so numb in mesmeration, mesmerized by the beauty of Sayyidina Yusuf, that it's reported that as they were cutting through the apples, they did not realize, you know, when your body becomes numb, Adrenaline takes over you, and you can't feel, and you play through that adrenaline. Such an adrenaline came through these women that they began to cut through their fingers, and they didn't feel it. Purely looking at the beauty of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. It's amazing, isn't it, that Allah Almighty described this moment, that when they were asked, they said, Hasha lillah, ma hadha basharun. Hasha lillah, ma hadha basharun. In huwa illa malakun kareem. Ma hadha basharun. This is not a human. It can't be a human. We have cut our fingers. This cannot be a human. Look at his beauty. In hadha illa malakun. This man, what is he? He is an angel that Allah has sent onto this earth. Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, when she heard this, she said, this was the beauty of Yusuf. Sayyidina Aisha reports, when asked about the beauty of Rasulullah salatu salam, that if the very same women of Egypt were to see just the cheek of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, they would not have cut their fingers. They would have ripped the hearts out of their chests and cut their hearts into pieces.
Narae Taqbeer! Allahu Akbar! Narae Risalat!
Ya Rasulullah!
Narae Haydri!
Ya Ali!
Usne Yusuf pe kati Misr mein angushte zana. See, the Ala Hazrat, Imam Ahl Sunnah Shah Ahmad Raza Fazl Bareilly rahmatullah alayh, explaining this, he coupled it into his poetry in Urdu. He said, Husne Yusuf pe kati, Misr mein angushte zana, sar katate hain tere naam pe mardane arab. Husne Yusuf pe kati, through the beauty of Sayyidina Yusuf, Misr mein angushte zana, the women began to cut their fingers looking at the beauty of Sayyidina Yusuf. Sayyidi Ala Hazrat, he closed this discussion when he said, Sar katate hain tere naam pe mardane arab. The men who fought in the armies of Rasulullah salatu salam, even after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they go and get their heads chopped off purely to defend Rasulullah salatu salam's honor. People are ready to die for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Where is Husn Yusuf? And where is the Husn and Kamal and Jamal of Rasulullah salatu salam? Nabi alayhi salatu salam was beauty personified in its entirety. Allah Almighty put Kamal, Husn and Jamal, complete Husn and Jamal in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, sometimes when you read through the ahadith, you will learn some sahaba describe Rasulullah salatu salam's blessed countenance, the blessed face, like the moon. Some said it was like the stars. One great sha'ir, one great alim al-arif billah, Sayyidi Abdullah Sirajuddin, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, muhaddith al-Halabi, muhaddith of Aleppo, he rahmatullahi alayhi, in his book Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, he said that you have Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. You can compare Sayyidina Yusuf to the moon in his beauty. Those women have the power in their eyes to look at Sayyidina Yusuf and be mesmerized by his beauty. Nabi alayhi salatu salam's beauty is like the sun. The sun is so beautiful, you can only take a few glimpses at a time. You can't look at the sun for long periods because you cannot handle the nur, the light that the sun comes. I've added a further equation and understanding to this. The moon scientifically is a reflection of the sun. The moon would not be the moon without the sun. Yusuf alayhi salam would not be Yusuf alayhi salam without Muhammad Rasulullah. Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam's nur came from the nur of Rasulullah salam. Yusuf alayhi salam's beauty came from the beauty of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidi Ala Hazrat Imam Ahl Sunnah, he said, wo kamal husn huzur hai, کہ غمان نقص جہاں نہیں، یہی پھول خار سے دور ہے، یہی شمع ہے کہ دھواں نہیں. اعلی حضرت عظیم المرتبہ محدث بریلی رحمت اللہ علیہ سید، وہ کمال حسن حضور ہے کہ غمان نقص جہاں نہیں. That what is the beauty, what is the excellence of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's beauty that one cannot even fathom any discrepancy to him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yahi phool khar se dur hai. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is like a flower that has no thorn. You know, a flower that has a thorn, it's an ad. It's a defect on that. You wouldn't want to pick that flower. Say the Allah Hazrat said Rasulullah sallam is that be-misal pool, that example of beauty, that it is not a case where you go to Rasulullah sallallahu sallam and you will find a default or a defect. Rasulullah sallallahu sallam is above all defects. Allah Almighty created Nabi sallallahu sallam perfect. Hence why Busiri rahmatullah alayhi said, munazzahun an shariqin fi mahasinihi. Munazzahun عن شريك في محاسنه فجوهر الحسن فيه غير منقسم. بصيري رحمة الله عليه said منزه منزه. Who is منزه? What does منزه mean? أبعد. He is free. He is far. عن شريك في محاسنه. From any partners in his beauty. Nobody can be equal in partnership with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's beauty. Allah Almighty created him so perfect in beauty that nobody can be equal to him in beauty, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَجَوْهَرُ الْحُسْنِ فِيهِ فَجَوْهَرُ الْحُسْنِ فِيهِ. That the beauty of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this diamond jawhar, this pearl of beauty that Allah Almighty placed in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, غَيْرْ مُنْكَسِمْ. Husayn rahmatullah alayhi said, it cannot be divided. Remember, in the Arabic language, according to the philosopher, Jawhar is what? Juz la yatajazza. Juz la yatajazza. It is an atom that cannot be divided any further. Busiri rahmatullah alayhi, whether you take the philosophical view on it, whether you take the linguistical view on it, he said, فَجَوْهَرُ الْحُسْنِ. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, the atom of beauty that Allah put in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is that beauty, that atom, that cannot be divided, it cannot be shared. Rasulullah salam's beauty was the most excellent beauty that Allah created on this earth. In the creation of Allah Jalla Jalalu, there is no one equal to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's beauty. Such is the beauty of Rasulullah salam. Sayyidina Hassan radiyallahu ta'ala an, he finishes these couplets by saying, وأحسن منك لم تركت عيني وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب. حسان said خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب. You was created perfect from every defect. You was created pure, free from every defect. Ya Rasulullah, whether we look in your blessed seerah, whether we look at your blessed khalq, whether we look at your blessed khilq, we look at your blessed khuluq, your character, your appearance, your surah, your seerah, Ya Rasulullah, we come to the conclusion that there is no defect inside you. Allah Almighty made you kamil and full of kamal and hasanat and excellences. He who believes or thinks that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam possesses a defect, he's kharij iman. He has lost his iman, he has lost his Islam, he has lost everything. Those who go around and say the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is like me and you, and they say it's in the Quran, in Surah Al-Kahf. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ. Say to them, O my beloved, you tell them, إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. I am a bashar like you. I am a human like you. I am a human like you. يُوحَى إِلَيَّ. Revelation comes to me. أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ. That your Lord is one. It's amazing, isn't it? That the very same people who quote this verse to me and you to prove Rasulullah is like me and you, they forget to read this end part. They forget to read Yuha ilayya. Nabi salatu salam was sent in human form. They were sent in physical form. They were sent so that people of that time could see them. Rasulullah was sent, but Allah Almighty sent revelation on him. Allah Almighty didn't send revelation on me and you. This is where the difference is. There is difference in everything. But here, based on this verse, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is not like me and you. Does Allah send revelation to you? Does Allah talk to you directly? No. So how are you like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? But still, Allah said in the Quran, we believe what Allah said in the Quran. But who did Allah address in this verse? Who was Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam talking to? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was talking to the mushrikeen of Makkah. The people who committed shirk, those who didn't understand Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, the Messenger of Allah addressing them said, I am a human like you, I have skin, you have skin. I have a nose, you have nose, I have eyes, you have eyes, I have hair, you have hair, I have height, you have height, I have all of this. But Allah Almighty talks to me, Allah doesn't talk to you. And then when you go to Bukhari and Muslim, and you go through all the books of Hadith, and you see the Sahaba, they used to fast 5 days, 6 days, 7 days without eating food, without breaking fast. We break fast at Maghrib without breaking fast, 6-7 days. Sawmul Wisal, they call it. The continuous fast. They only did this because it was the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do this. When the Messenger of Allah seen that there were people missing the gatherings, they were coming. Because they physically could not be able to fast 5, 6, 7 days without food and drink. The Messenger of Allah said to them, Ayyukum mithli, which one of you is like me? Who is like me? Lastuka ahadun minkum, I am not like any one of you. Lastuka hay'atikum, my hay'a is not like your hay'a. I am not like you, you are not like me. Ya Rasulullah, in the Quran it says that I am like you, you have said. And in the hadith it says that who is like me? None of you is like me. How do we consolidate? The Quran is talking to the mushrikeen, munkirin of Rasulullah. And those, when Nabi wasalam, is telling that I am not like you, you are not like me, who is like me? Nabi wasalam, is talking to the mu'mineen, the people of Iman. We are the people of Iman. We are being addressed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he alayhi salatu wasalam said, Ayyukum mithli, who is like me? The Sahaba didn't stand up and say, Ya Rasulullah, you have eyes, we have eyes. They knew Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has eyes. But whose eyes are like Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam's eyes? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam would lead the prayer. And they used to say, be careful when you go into ruku and sujood. I can see from behind me that you go into ruku and sujood before me. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, when the Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, such was the beauty of Rasulullah salatu wasalam's blessed eyes. They could see in darkness just as they would see clearly in light. That very famous story of Sayyidah Aisha when she dropped the needle. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam entered the room and they smiled. They smiled, such rays of beauty came from their blessed face that it illuminated the room, and Sayyidah Aisha said, the needle I lost, I found.
Subhanallah.
This is mentioned by Al-Hakim al-Tirmizi rahmatullah, not Imam al-Tirmizi, Hakim al-Tirmizi rahmatullah alayh, one of the great muhaddithin that came after their time. And like this, so much can be said. All night we can talk about the excellences and the beauties of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My brothers and sisters, the message I want to leave you is, study the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Study the shama'il of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Study the blessed appearance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Your whole life's mission should be, your whole life's objective should be, that I want to see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is what we should be aiming for. This is, should be our objective. If somebody asks you, what's your purpose? You should say, my purpose of existence is that I see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That these worthless eyes have the honor of doing ziyarah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is what our objective and purpose is. In order for us to do this, we must study his life. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Know, have ilm, that amongst you is the Messenger of Allah. Allah is ordering us to know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How many of us know who Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is? We know they are our Nabi and Rasul. They are our Mawla and Aka. We know this. But what do you know? How much do you know? When you know, then you build the passion and yearning. When you've been reading so much, eventually you get to a stage where you want to see. I want to see this beauty. This is the level that you need to get to. Where you want to see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For he who has been blessed to see the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, certainly has seen Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I finish with this hadith. Man ra'ani faqad ra'al haqq. Whoever has seen me, certainly has seen the truth. فَإِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَا يَتَمَثَّنُونِي أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. For indeed the devil, the shaytan, he cannot impersonate me. If you've seen me in your dream, then you have seen me in your dream. The devil cannot impersonate me in the dream. He cannot take my form. Allah has made it haram on the devil to take the form of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, proving my point that nobody is equal to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nobody's beauty is equal to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's beauty. Nobody's kamal is equal to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's kamal and hasanat. My brothers and sisters, keep this in mind. And in these gatherings, please, I urge you, don't just sit there. Send durood and salam on the Prophet alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Sallallahu ala Muhammad, sallallahu ala Muhammad, sallallahu. Send this as much as you can. You are sat in the gatherings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are not mine and your gatherings. Build your connection with Rasulullah alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah Jalla Jalaluhu bless each and every one of us. Wa akulu qawli hadha. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Wa akhru da'wana. Alhamdulillah.